Hi, beautiful people. It's Courtney. Welcome back. If you're new here, welcome to the fam. Today, I wanted to do a bit of a throwback video to something I used to do quite a bit, which were these like TMI life hack for girls video. I love these because I feel like I could connect to you guys on a more personal level, do a little big sis, little sis type of advice video. I don't know. I just really like them, and I remember you guys always liked when I posted these, so I hope you enjoy like a little change of pace video for today. Before I jump into it, I do want to ask you guys for a huge, huge, huge favor. If you are not already subscribed, please click that subscribe button. I am trying to reach 500,000 followers by the end of September, so that would be amazing. I'm going to have a huge giveaway for you guys if we can get there. First things first, let's talk about periods, because that's something us girls, we all got to deal with. And over the years, I have found so many different helpful things to do that have really made my life so much easier that when I'm actually on my period, I no longer feel like I even have a period. So before I knew how to deal with all my symptoms, I had really bad periods. I had extremely bad cramps. I had bad headaches. I still get migraines, but they're not related to my period. And then I would actually like pass out because the pain was so bad. That would often happen like in the middle of the night when I got up to use the bathroom. I would usually pass out along with it. Like fainting has become second nature to me. So luckily, I no longer have to experience that on a monthly basis. And there's quite a few things I've done to help with that. Now, I used to take a lot of medicine, which for the past year or two, I've really tried to stray away from. I was on birth control and I just stopped taking it because after years of taking it, I just wanted all those chemicals out of my body. It did help with my period, but I knew I needed to find a different solution because it's just, I don't know, I don't like the concept of putting like hormones and stuff. I do feel like you should always be protected, but like with the pill, I don't know. I just don't like the concept of like taking a bunch of medicine. So I've cut out medicine from my life like tenfold. So along with that goes painkillers. I hate taking painkillers when I'm on my period just for cramps and stuff like that. So I have found a new all-natural way to help with period pain that I wanted to share with you guys. So it is this little device here, and it is called the Soak and Stop, and it just has this little handle. Then it has like these sensors on here. It comes with the plug that you plug into the wall, and it also comes with the silken gel that you use along with it to help it glide on your skin. This little thing here will give you long-lasting pain relief, and after the first time I used it for like 10, 15 minutes. You could use it in like 15-minute sessions, and it completely got rid of the pain. So like I said, I like to use this for about 15 minutes, and after you use it once or twice, it helps get rid of your period pain for the rest of your period. So it's super, super nice. It's effective the longer you use it, and I just think it's really cool. It has awesome technology. If you guys are interested in the technology, I'll share a little bit of that with you now. So to understand how this little guy works, it's helpful to know why you get period pain so you can understand the science behind it. I'm a little science nerd, so I like this kind of stuff. But basically, during your period, your muscles in the uterus contract and they shed the inner lining, which is why you bleed. But when you have strong contractions like that, that's what causes a slower blood flow into your uterus, and it really deprives your muscle of oxygen, so that's what causes the pain. So what the Soak and Stop does is it provides three proven technologies: bipolar radio frequency, low-level therapy, and infrared heat energy, which I'm sure you guys have heard of some of those. But basically, the energies go into your body to treat the pain, and it generates an increased tissue and cell activity. That way, it leads to a natural pain relief. And the heat and the muscle widens your blood vessels, just like heat is very good for your blood vessels and widening them. That way there's more blood flow, and it really helps restore the oxygen that it was lacking in the first place and causing the pain. But it's super easy to use. You apply the gel, you turn it on with the little button, and then you just massage the area, and it feels amazing. It feels like a heating pad. It just feels really, really nice, except it works like a million times better than an actual heating pad. Now, another point that's kind of unrelated to periods that I did want to share with you, because I deal with back pain a lot. It runs in my family. My mom has degenerative disc disease. She's had like two back surgeries, two neck surgeries, and her back kills her all the time. She used this, and one time she could feel like a lot of relief from it. So I'm gonna let her be borrowing this a lot to just try to help with that. And Andy gets neck pain, so it really works in any problem areas that you have pain, not just your period pain. So this is like a multi-use thing for me that I'll be using. I have herniated disc in my back, so when I have like bad back pain, I use this little guy. and it helps so much. So it's actually on pre-sale right now, so if you're interested in getting it, you could click the link down below for 50% off, which is the best deal you're gonna get on this. This is incredible to get it half off for such amazing technology. I think it's really cool. Now the next thing I wanted to share with you guys that has been another huge lifesaver is the Diva Cup. This combined with the Silken Stop makes me feel like I don't even have a period anymore. Basically, I've been using this for like 3 or 4 years now. I've done a full dedicated video on this, so I'll link that down below and keep this one pretty short. But this has been absolutely life-changing. I am someone who's very squeamish and grossed out by stuff like a menstrual cup, but it's really not bad at all. I got my sister onto it and she loves it and thinks it makes such a good difference. It's good for the environment, it saves you money, there's no toxins, there's nothing in it. It's amazing. I cannot recommend this enough. Like, more and more information is coming out that tampons aren't good for you, they have toxins in them, and they're also not good to leave in for long periods of time. Like, you're really not supposed to wear tampons while you sleep, and I'm just not a pad person at all. So menstrual cups are just the way to go for me. They last up to 12 hours. Sometimes I even push that a little further, although you're not supposed to, but it is just a huge, huge difference. I'll link the full review down below if you want to hear more about it, but I would highly recommend giving it a try. It takes a couple months to get used to it, but it is a game changer. Number three is another period hack. Like I mentioned, I stopped taking birth control, and back when I did take it, my periods were super, super regular. Now they're not really, they are, but they aren't, and I don't exactly know. It's harder to keep track of when I'm gonna get it without having the little pills telling me which day I'm gonna start. So what I use is the Clue app. You guys have probably heard of this. It's very popular. I like it. It tells you when you're gonna start your period based on your previous period. Sometimes it's off by a day or two, but it's usually pretty accurate, and it also tells you when you're ovulating and all that good stuff. So if you're trying to get pregnant, it could help you like that. If you're trying to not to get pregnant, it could also help you with that. So yeah, I just use that to keep track. That's the app that I have found and just use. So that's what I've been using that probably for like since I stopped birth control, maybe like 2 years ago. So that's what I use. Now this next little tip or hack that I have is I like to use like the Summer's Eve, or like the generic version of it, same difference, the Summer's Eve like pH body wash. This is great for, you can use it as a regular body wash, but it's also great for your lady parts because it's just a pH balance. It makes everything smell nice, not gonna irritate you. You don't want to use anything with like perfume because that could definitely irritate your body, and so I like to use a pH balance, especially I use that to clean like my Diva cup and stuff, so I just have that for that time of month. I don't know if you guys know this, but different fabrics react really differently in regards to like sweat and body odors when it comes to both your clothes, your workout clothes, your underwear. So I like to stay away from synthetic underwear. I find like they just trap odors more. They aren't as good as absorbing sweat or anything like that if you're at the gym or it's just hot outside. So I really like to use cotton all the way. I also really like wool. Wool is expensive, but I've really been turned on to wool lately. I have like wool socks to hike in and they just make such a difference. I have like this wool base layer I got for like snowboarding in the winter time and all of that. So I really like wool. Wool is very expensive. They also make wool underwear, and despite the connotation that wool might be itchy or scratchy, I don't find it to be that at all. They make really nice quality wool items now. So that's really good if you're super into like outdoorsy stuff. Wool is the way to go, but day to day I would stick with cotton over synthetic fabrics. I just feel like they work a lot better at concealing, hiding, not causing odors, and yeah, that's just what I would highly recommend. Now I have one more little underwear hack before we get into like other girl hacks, but for underwear, I feel like I love this little way of folding underwear because it really conceals them whether you're traveling or you're just throwing it in your bag or staying at your friend's house. You know, you might be digging through your book bag. I know when I was on the swim team, I had to bring like a change of clothes with me, and I definitely did not want my underwear falling out of my bag for everyone to see. So if you fold it in this little cool way that I'm showing you here, you could basically roll it up and then tuck the ends into itself, and it will just make this like compact little roll. You can't tell if it's a tank top, you can't tell if it's underwear, and it just makes it really compact in your bag, and no one can see your underwear like flying out. If they did, it just looks like some fabric. Next, I have some shaving hacks for you. I hate shaving, let's be real. I honestly want to get like laser hair removal. So number one, always use shaving cream. It gets such a nice close shave versus if you don't. You could also use conditioner for this, but definitely just don't shave your legs dry. You need something to help moisturize it as the razor glides across your skin. So once you shave your legs normally, you can create your own DIY leg scrub or body scrub, or you could use one that you already have. So you could use like olive oil and sugar, you could use a exfoliator you already have, but you want to use that exfoliator on your legs after you shave it, and it's really going to help get rid of all that extra dead skin and just really make your legs nice and smooth. So after you remove the dead skin, if you shave your legs one more time, they will be so smooth like a baby's bottom. It makes a huge difference. Or even if you don't want to shave again and you just use an exfoliator after to get rid of all the dead skin, it makes a huge, huge difference and makes your legs so nice and smooth. Now another shaving hack I like to do, which seems a little weird to admit, I don't know why more women don't talk about this, but I like to shave my face on occasion. Not like the full Santa Claus beard shaving cream, but in this area I get like really light peach fuzz and baby hairs, and they actually make these really cool women's electric razors now that you can use like for lip hair if you have it, or like I get it here. I have like long sideburns, so mine come like the sideburn itself doesn't come down, but then I have like little light hair here. So for the peach fuzz hair, I like to shave it. Like for my sideburn itself, I don't shave dark hair because then it will grow back like stubble. But anything that's kind of like peach fuzz, I would highly recommend shaving it. And then your makeup applies so much smoother. Your skin feels so soft. I don't know. I just think it's a really cool thing. Now on to my last tip. This comes with, again, getting nice, clear, smooth skin. And this is something I've been doing recently. I never used to take super good care of my skin, but there's actually a proper way you should be applying all your different face serums and moisturizers. So just a little trick slash tip that I like to do to remember is when you're applying all your different face creams, moisturizers, serums, there gets to be a lot of stuff. Basically, you want to apply them from the thinnest consistency to the thickest. So for example, what I like to do in my own personal routine, I still try to keep it like not too complicated, only a few products, but I like to wash my face with the cleanser, then exfoliate it to get all the dead skin off. And that's, I do that while I'm in the shower. And then once I get out, I like to use a toner to help balance the pH. So once the toner just kind of sets, I like to use a serum, which is very lightweight. It absorbs into your skin really fast. And then that's when I like to go in with my moisturizer. Sometimes after the serum, I like to go in with a retinol cream and then I'll use a moisturizer, or sometimes I'll just jump straight to the moisturizer. But I always do the moisturizer last, or do like a face oil last, just because it's so thick and so you want it to be the very last thing you put on your face. So that was a little trick. I never really thought to put that together, like the thinnest product should go first. And then I did a ton of research on skincare and I was like, oh, that makes total sense. So I wanted to share that with you guys. I don't know. I hope you guys found this video helpful. These are my favorite tips that just make my life a whole lot easier. So maybe you could learn a new thing or two that you would like to try out. Thank you guys so much for watching though. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you made it to the very end, you're part of my hashtag girl squad because I love you girls. And so if you missed my past few videos, you could click on over to the side of me and I'll talk to you very soon. Bye.